Hey, listen. Is it really true that you guys received $5 million from your husband's parents after they passed away?
What?
Oh, I guess I meant that Dave got $5 million from his parents' will, right? Man, but really, who would have thought that his parents had that kind of money just sitting around all the way until their passing? I so wonder why I ended up divorcing a man like him now. Had I known about all that cash, then I would have never left him.
I'm sorry, but who is this?
Oh, I'm sorry for getting so carried away there. I'm Dave's ex-wife, Catalina. And you should be Summer, right? You and him got married around 10 years ago, correct?
That's true, but how come you know my phone number? And how do you know about my husband's money that he just received?
There is nothing in this world I don't know about. And one of those things that I started to know about recently was that my ex got married again. I don't get it though, considering he told me that he'd love me forever and ever. Well, this is probably another reason why I chose to divorce him back then.
Well, when you stab someone in the back and then divorce them, they tend to stop loving you anymore.
Huh?
I've heard quite a bit about you myself from Dave. You just got up and vanished one day out of Dave's sight without ever telling him, right? There was another man you ran off with, right? And that's why you left him with a stack of divorce papers on the counter that you had already gone through and filled out. That's all I've heard from Dave about what happened then.
Oh my, so you do know about what happened between us. Well, since you seem to know so much about me as well, that'll help moving this conversation along. There is actually a very good reason for why I'm contacting you today. I'm sorry to ask this, but can you please go tell Dave that he needs to hand me all that money he got from his parents?
What? You want me to tell him that he needs to give you that $5 million?
Yes, that's right. And the reason I ask is that because I'm his ex-wife, I also have a right to that money.
Huh?
I've been trying to contact Dave about this time after time already, but ever since the divorce, he's been ignoring me completely. That's why I had no other choice but to look up his wife's contact info and reach out to her. Therefore, can I ask you to please send him that message I've told you?
Hold on for one moment. Why do you think you have any right to that money he inherited from his parents?
Because I have the right. I mean, back when I was married to him, I had to live together with his parents at their house.
Huh?
Back when living with his parents, every day was so hard for me. As his wife, I was forced to do all the chores there. I had to cook for everyone and clean for everyone. Literally anything his parents and him didn't want to do was given to me. But because of all that work I put in, you can say that I was a better caretaker for both his parents than Dave was, right? That's why, as a thank you for all that time and effort I sacrificed, I should be given at least a percentage of that inheritance.
As a thank you?
I've heard from many people before that as someone who took care of them while they were growing older and older, I have a right to some of their things. So considering that I put in all that work for those two, shouldn't I get something in return now? At the very least? I think $100,000 would be enough to satisfy me.
$100,000 at the very least?
It was so hard having to live with his parents. You should be able to understand where I'm coming from here since you're his current wife. Don't you think that's a fair amount to be asking for right now?
Not at all.
The only thing I'm thinking right now is when is this clown gonna shut up?
I've heard all about the time you had to live with his parents alongside him, and as far as I can tell, what you got in the end is what you deserved. Wasn't the reason for you having to live with them in the first place the fact that you went and used up all Dave's money that was meant for a new house on yourself? And so as a punishment for that, he had you and himself move back in with his parents and made sure they worked you enough to make up for all that money of his.
What?
Dave's even gone and told you about all of that part as well? From what all I've been told, you were forcing Dave to work and bring in all his money for your sake. He had even tried to ask you to take some time off from doing the chores if you wanted, as long as you got a part-time job or something to help bring in money for your spending. Yet you never listened to him and just continued to use him as though he was your wallet or something. He told me that every time he'd confront you, all you'd reply with is saying that you only wanted to do the most simple chores in the house. Therefore, there was never a moment where you went and helped Dave earn more money for the house by getting a part-time job. And then, when you started to get upset with his parents for working you all the time in their home, you would leave at night to go mess around with another man. So, can you tell me again, Catalina, what part of all that is a good enough reason for you getting any bit of that inheritance he got from his parents? You're a real annoyance, aren't you? Just because you're his frickin' wife does not mean you get to talk to me like that. You're the one that ended up marrying my leftovers, so do you really think that someone in your position can talk to me like that right now? Excuse me? I want to talk with Dave about all this, so shut the hell up and go let him know I need to talk. Stop trying to get in my frickin' way when all I'm asking for is $100,000 from him. I wasn't trying to get in the way of you or Dave, to be fair. Well, then you shut up and do as I asked. Now, you go and let Dave know what I've said. You're going to tell him all the details, right? Dave, can you talk for a second? I know you probably don't want to talk about this, but I have news for you from your ex.
From Catalina?
Just a little bit ago, she had texted me about this. She told me that she's been trying to get in touch with you, but you kept ignoring her, so she had to talk to me instead.
Could this all be about her wanting part of the inheritance?
Yep. She wants $100,000 from you, at the very least. She says that she deserves the money after having to live and work with your parents for a few years.
I thought that by ignoring all her constant calls and texts that she'd give up, but no. She actually went ahead and started talking to you. I'm sorry, Summer. You shouldn't have to be involved in all of this.
No worries, Dave. It's not your fault. But seeing her trying this hard to get a bit of that money from you... Did she really live that difficult of a life with your parents back when you told her she needed to go help them? She was telling me about how she was forced into doing everything for them for years as their caretaker.
Huh? How was any of that difficult for her? She told me she didn't want to work a part-time job at all, so I sent her there to help them with their chores. But every single day was the worst. When it came to her cooking, she'd still go out to the store and pick up pre-made foods for both my parents and I. And when the doctor started to tell my parents that they needed to stop taking in so much salt, Catalina went ahead and continued to feed them more fried foods. She would never put any effort into cleaning the house and would just sit around complaining about having to pick up a few crumbs off the floor or something.
The fact that she thinks she deserves even $100,000 from you all for that is crazy. I've already tried to tell her off myself now. But I'm thinking it would be better that you got in touch with her one time and told her to leave us alone yourself. What do you think?
No, just having to talk to her in general is a waste of time. That's why I'm just going to continue to ignore her, and you should do the same.
But by doing something like that to her, she'll never understand that you literally won't give her a penny and might continue to try harder and harder to talk to you. I think you should get in touch with her once and let her know that the money is not hers, and that her piss-poor effort while married to you will not be met with any reward. I get that ignoring her is the easier thing to do here, but over time it's going to start to wear you down even.
Well, I suppose it's a good point, but I really don't want anything to do with that witch anymore. I don't even think she'll listen to a thing I say to her if I take the time to reach out.
Let's just try our best, Dave. We don't have to convince her to agree with our stance or anything, just as long as we explain the situation with that money to her. Also, if you continue to ignore her all the time, she's just going to keep trying to talk to me about all this.
I wouldn't want that either. You have nothing to do with any of this. So she should just stick to me and leave you the hell alone. All right, fine. Guess I have no other choice but to go and tell that witch off. I really, really don't feel good about all of this, but I guess it wouldn't hurt me too much to have to talk with her.
I'm so sorry, Summer, but it looks like I'll be getting that $5 million from Dave after all. Excuse me? But this is all because of you as well, right? You went ahead and told him what I was asking for me. You are much like Dave's and my Cupid right now. I'm not really sure what all you're talking about right now, so could you please walk me through again what's happened? Actually, just a little while ago, I got in touch with Dave again. I thought he was calling me to say that he'd be sending me some money soon, but instead, he actually asked to come and see me in person. He said he had some really important stuff he wanted to talk to me about. And considering it had been so long since we last saw one another, he asked if we could talk over lunch or dinner. This has to be him trying to get back with me, right? He's going to come with all that money he inherited and propose to me again like he did so long ago. I'm not sure that's what's going to happen at all. I'm sure you just have the wrong idea here, so could you please keep all of that to yourself from now on? Wait, how is any of this the wrong idea? I happen to be prettier than you and use all kinds of higher-end cosmetics than you. I know for a fact that he's going to want to get back with me, and that's why he's coming out to talk with me in person. Huh? And another thing with Dave. For the longest time now, he's been ignoring me, right? But when I sent him a picture of myself looking my very best, he started to reply to me again like things had never changed. And that's when he told me he had something he wants to talk about, so we'll meet in public to have that talk. You sent him a picture of yourself? You would really do something like that to someone else's husband? Well, starting really soon, he's going to be coming back to me, so what's the big deal? I am so, so, so looking forward to the dinner we'll be having soon. I think I'll wear a really nice dress today to prepare for that proposal he has for me. Oh, but there's also a chance that tonight we'll be staying out at the same hotel, so I need to be ready for that. I'll make sure to get myself all prepared for that as well now, too. Would you cut all that out right now? Dave is not going out to see you with the intent of getting back together. I understand that you want to think something like that, but Dave is back to being focused on me again. That's why after so many years of ignoring me, he's finally stopped trying to evade me and is coming right back. You're going to be tossed aside in only a couple more hours, so you'd better get yourself ready for that divorce. What? I need to get a head start on filling out all the papers for our marriage now as well, then. He's already putting in all the work to finally come back to me tonight, so the least I could do is get that paperwork all ready. And then both Dave and all that inheritance will be mine. Dave's parents are still alive, you know. What? I can't do this anymore. There's no way I can ask Dave to go and meet with someone as mentally unstable as you now. So in order to keep him away from you, I'll tell you everything you need to know right now. All of the things you've been confused about this whole time. Confused about what? By the way, what the hell are you talking about by saying his parents are still alive? Dave just got $5 million as an inheritance from them. If his parents hadn't died, then how would he be able to get that kind of money from them? You are partially correct. Dave did, in fact, get $5 million as an inheritance. But whoever told you that money came from his parents?
Huh? Well, just by hearing that, wouldn't it normally be the case that he got the money from his dead parents? Let me ask you this, actually. If it wasn't from his parents that he got that inheritance, then who the hell did it come from?
From your parents, Catalina.
Huh? From mine?
Yes, that's right. Your parents went ahead and gave Dave $5 million after they passed away. It was written in their will that he get that amount of money, so there was no way we could say no to it. The lawyer told us when handing over the money that your parents wanted him to have the money as a way of saying sorry for their terrible daughter. And that even though he wasn't related to them by blood or anything, he was still like a son to them. So that's what ended up happening.
Huh? No way in hell that happened. Stop trying to lie about something as serious as that.
I'm just telling you the truth is all.
How is any of that the truth? My family is just your average family, and neither of my parents would have ever had $5 million just sitting around. And hold on, they aren't even dead yet. So tell me, when did they actually die, and what would have made them give their daughter's ex all of that money? I have no idea what you're going on about right now, and I might consider you more mentally unstable than myself right now.
I'm sure to you, both of your parents may have seemed like any other family. But in reality, those two were very good at saving up money. And I'm really sorry to have to break it to you this way, but your parents are long gone.
What? You're really going to continue telling me that sick joke?
This must mean you had no idea what happened then. That's why Dave wanted to meet with you in person. And actually, it was me that convinced him to go out and talk with you in person about all the important details. And, well, that all happened around the same time you sent him that picture of yourself to try and get him to talk. Dave has never, ever thought of getting back together with you, and to be honest, he doesn't even really want to see you in person.
Wait a second. It's not that I don't understand you, but rather I'm totally blanking on what's happening right now. What do you even mean when you say that my parents have passed away?
Later on, you can listen to what Dave has to tell you when it comes to your parents' passing. And when that time comes, you will listen to him in a serious manner and will stop trying to talk about getting back together again, right? Now, I need to get going.
Thank you so much, Summer. You really did me a huge favor by bringing a lot of that stuff up with Catalina before I had a talk with her. Because of that, the whole time she remained quiet and listened to me, and the whole conversation went over smoothly.
That's great to hear. But how was Catalina when you saw her?
You could say she was looking really sad, but I think it was just all the shock that was making her look that way. But that's what'll happen, right? She had no idea her own parents passed away and had to be told today by her ex's wife.
That's right. She had all that information crammed into her head today, so of course she'd be frozen stiff from being in shock.
But this is just another step in the ladder of things she's had coming for her all this time, right? Back when her dad passed away in that car accident, she never answered any of the calls her mother gave her. And then when her mother passed away from that illness a couple of years later, she didn't answer any of the calls from the hospital.
Even after all those calls from both the hospital and her family, she never bothered to call back, huh? Had she just answered one of those calls, she wouldn't have had to live frozen in shock like she is now.
But there was a reason for why she never answered any of those calls from anyone then. So it's unfortunate that she never got to be with her family during either of her parents' deaths, but that's on her. You remember me telling you about how the divorce happened, right? About how Catalina ran off with the man she was cheating on me with and left me the divorce papers? At the time, she had borrowed money from my family in order to run away from me. The reason we never had enough money to move up from my parents' house and get a place of our own is because she borrowed $50,000 from them, and they took that from me thereafter.
Wait, really?
She had cried and begged for my mom and dad to give her some money so that she could get away because living with them was too hard. And so in the end, they gave her $50,000, thinking she'd use it with me to get us a house or an apartment. But in the end, we found out she was using that money to run away. And we only found that out after we got a call a few days later from where she told me she was gone for good. After that last call, though, she never answered any more of our calls or texts, and so we thought that was the end of her.
So that's why she was never answering any of her family's calls to her either? Or any calls, for that matter?
Which is crazy because her dad's accident and mother's illness all happened years after that. Yet she was still dodging any call or text people gave her. Had she just answered someone, then none of this would have ever happened to her now. And you and I could be living without her bothering us.
Now that you mention all of that, your mom really wanted to find Catalina and talk with her again, right?
When you and I got married, there was another couple at the wedding you may have remembered, right? They were around my parents' age and both wore very standard formal wear. Those were Catalina's parents, and ever since she ran off, they had been very close to me. That's why I felt I needed to go see her mom when she was in the hospital, and why I was there for both her mom and dad's funerals. I was even there to help with her mom's bedside care for some time before she had to go to the hospital. I just never thought that continued relationship with them would end with them writing me down in their will for $5 million.
I remember that day so clearly, Dave. That lawyer called you out of nowhere, and before we could even ask what the call was about, he was telling you there was an inheritance that you needed to receive. And when we went in to get it, it turned out to be $5 million. I almost passed out when I heard that number from the lawyer. Your ex's mother really left you with more than anyone was ever expecting, huh?
Had Catalina actually stayed in touch with her parents, she might have actually gotten some money from them. She could have used that time she might have had left with her parents to apologize for what she did and all that.
Well, I think her not getting a single penny from them is what she deserves. But I wonder if after hearing all of this from you and I, will she be willing to give up now?
The only option she has now is to give up. The reason all of this is happening to her is her own fault. And if she really still wants to have a piece of this money, then she can go talk to the lawyer about it. I'm sure he can get the point across to her that this is what her mom wanted.
Well, let's just call this the end then. Good work, Dave. I'll make you a small meal for when you get home, and then I'll get the bath all ready for you so that you can calm your nerves a little. Give me back my inheritance! That $5 million should be going to me! Why do I have to sit here and let that money go to my ex and his wife now? You already heard about everything from Dave yesterday, right? You never answered any of your family's calls or texts, and so this is what you get for completely ignoring all of them. Shut the hell up! I am going to go over there and steal all that money back right now! I'll make sure all $5 million are back in my hands. What? I never actually knew my own parents had all that money saved up before their deaths. I could have sworn they didn't have much money at all, and they never once lived like celebrities or anything like that while I was around. And how was I even supposed to know my dad got into an accident and died, and that my mom became sick a year later and passed from that? How the hell could they just give Dave all their money just because I didn't answer some stupid phone calls? I will not let this happen to me. If you have some complaints about how things turned out, why don't you go and tell that to their gravestones? They were the ones that chose to give Dave this money, so you have to talk to them. Shut up! I am tired of talking about this with you, so get that goddamn money together and wait for me to come over and get it. I'll be bringing a lawyer along with me who knows all about that kind of stuff as well, so you won't be able to say a single thing. I'll make sure that $5 million all comes back to me. I guess there's really no other option now. If that's how you're going to behave, then so will Dave and I. You are more than welcome to come here with that lawyer of yours. But know that the moment you step foot on our property, you will be owing my husband $50,000. Huh? $50,000? What the hell is that money for? That happens to be the amount of money you borrowed from Dave's parents, right? You do remember when you went and took that money from them, making it seem like you and Dave would be getting a new place, only to run off and use the money to get away from Dave, right? I remember all of that, but why do I have to pay that back? The parents I got that money from are both dead now. The thing is, though, it's your parents who are dead and Dave's who are still around. And since you took that money from them, they are asking for it back now. What? Back after the divorce, your parents actually got in touch with Dave's and handed them $50,000 so that Dave didn't have to end up paying his parents anything for what you'd done. However, when your dad passed away, your mom wrote in the will for Dave that he would be getting both the $5 million and the $50,000 that you should be owing your parents, who are now both gone. So, Catalina, you have to pay Dave $50,000 now. What did you say? Even though the people you should have owed that money to are gone now, you will still have that debt in your name forever. And, well, the person to receive that money from you was passed over to Dave in the will as well. You did say you'd be bringing a pretty strong lawyer along with you, right? I won't even have to explain anything to him then, because all he'll have to do is have a look at the will and that'll be all. Wow. I never thought you'd bring a pro in all that legal work along with you to pay us that $50,000 back. That is so very helpful of you, Catalina. Wait. I don't care about any of that crap, so you're not getting any $50,000 from me. You really think saying you don't care about the law will make a lawyer turn a blind eye to you? Well, if that's the case, then I suppose we can just say we don't care about you getting this $5 million from us, and so you won't be getting anything. Huh? Now I have to get going. If you still have things to complain about to us for some reason, then please bring us that $50,000 and then we'll listen. And after that last text from me, I never got another message from her again. I made sure to tell Dave about what she was saying just in case, and he told me he really doesn't care about the $50,000 from her since he already got $5 million. And actually, he said it was good that I made that remark about the $50,000, because that should be enough to keep her out of our hair for the rest of the time. As for what Catalina's been up to after all that, she started to go around telling loan sharks and such that her husband had $5 million coming his way and used that lie in order to borrow large amounts of money. However, since that was a lie and the loan sharks are starting to figure all that out, she's been having a really hard time running from all their goons. Recently, we had heard some more news about her and what happened regarding those loan sharks. And it turns out that some of them were far scarier than even she thought, which led to Catalina no longer being in the U.S. anymore.